When the FCCI put up the first statement on imitation is the best form of flattery, was it before Mr. Mendoza came out to claim his rights? Since Mr. Mendoza had came out originally to claim his rights, after we have done our check on our rights, why didn't we actually press the issue further and ask him to admit plagiarism rather than just letting him go like that? In Singapore, we are aiming to be, aspiring to be the global or regional arbitration center. Dealing with such infringement of IP rights lightly will affect our aspirations to be that. Can the minister clarify, please?
The original post by MCCY was before Mr. Mendoza surfaced. As I explained earlier, the first video or the first series of videos were of school children in a respectful setting using the song, albeit without permission. And it was in that context that the first message that Mr. Leong refers to was put up. Subsequently, when Mr. Mendoza asserted his claim, as I explained in my answer earlier, and Mr. Mendoza's assertion was a direct challenge to our own ownership and proprietary interest in the songs, then things took a different turn, and we pressed Mr. Mendoza to withdraw his claims, which brings me to my second point. As I explained earlier, Mr. Mendoza did in fact admit that he has no ownership interest. He's got no evidence to substantiate his position that he lays any claim to the song. He withdraws his position that he previously took on We Can Achieve. So to Mr. Leong's point about assertion of interest in our copyright, assertion of our position and our ownership of such copyright, that was what we did precisely with Mr. Mendoza. Mr. Leong should not also confuse asserting our rights with necessarily taking legal action, legal proceedings. They're not necessarily the same thing. And in this case, it was far more efficient, quicker, and a lot more effective for Mr. Mendoza to be persuaded that his own position was untenable, for his claims to be withdrawn by himself, and not in any way removing the Singapore government, and in fact for all Singaporeans' interest in the songs, to be preserved. To address Mr. Leong Man Wai's question about the actions the Ministry has taken to protect Singapore's copyright in the case of a composer plagiarising the song Count on Me Singapore, let me set out details of this incident. We first received feedback that the song We Can Achieve was featured in several videos, some of which were of school children, apparently from India, singing the song. This song was almost identical to Count on Me Singapore, save for minor differences such as replacing the word Singapore with India, and a line in the song which goes, "We are told no dreams to hold that we can strive for." In the videos, the students appeared to be expressing their love for their country, and the song was not disrespectfully treated. The publisher of the song, We Can Achieve, subsequently came forward to acknowledge that the song seemed to be substantially copied from Count on Me Singapore and apologised for it, as well as removed it from their platforms. We did not believe that there was any ill will or malice intended, and hence accepted this apology. Shortly after, one Mr. Joey Mendoza, he then alleged that he had, in fact, was the one who wrote the song We Can Achieve in 1983. This was an untenable assertion, given that this song, as I mentioned earlier, was practically identical to Count on Me Singapore. If his claim was right, it would be a direct affront to our own ownership and interest in the national song Count on Me Singapore. We thus pressed Mr. Mendoza to substantiate his claims. If he could not, then he should withdraw them. We were prepared to initiate legal proceedings, if necessary, to protect our position. At the same time, we also undertook extensive fact-checking in Singapore and in India to refute Mr. Mendoza's claims. We obtained confirmation of contemporaneous and documentary evidence of the writing of the song Count on Me Singapore. Mr. Jeremy Montero, a respected musician and cultural medallion recipient, was witness to the events at the material time, contemporaneously. Members might have read his account in the news of how he worked alongside Mr. Hugh Harrison when Mr. Harrison composed the song in 1986. In response to our request for proof of his claim and to substantiate his position, Mr. Mendoza then changed his position. He subsequently withdrew his claims. He admitted that he had no evidence to support his claims and confirmed the following in writing: that he unconditionally and irrevocably withdraws all claims to the lyrics and music of the song We Can Achieve, which he recognises is similar to Count on Me Singapore. that he had informed all his associates and networks of the above, and also instructed all social media platforms to pull down the song We Can Achieve with immediate effect, and that he had no intention of attacking the integrity or professionalism of Mr. Harrison, the original composer of Count on Me Singapore. The legislation around the use of the national symbols and the government's stance on copyright of the national songs are intended to prevent misuse that might diminish or denigrate the standing of such symbols and songs. At the same time, we should not take umbrage at every such use and resort to legal remedies each time. A careful judgment is made in each case as to whether, and if so, what action is to be taken along the considerations which I've outlined above.